Somerville, I'm the Chuck in the Market sub Chuck, and pardon me, but I have a little laryngitis this morning, so I'm going to try to be more brief than normal. But today's blog is basically based on the rate of change of earnings growth, or how the velocity of earnings growth actually affects shareholder returns. So I'm going to show four examples here of accelerating, various but accelerating growth rates. I'm going to start with a utility, California Water Service, 15-year chart. I want you to notice they had about 4% growth. They do pay a nice dividend yield, which is, you know, common to utilities, so they did throw off some nice dividend. But $100,000 investment in this, you know, 3%, 4% grower, you know, gave the shareholder return about 5.5%. The difference can always be explained by valuation. And that's just modestly better than the market. But I do want you to notice even this company did better than the general stock market during this period of time. A faster grower over the same 15-year period would be Avon Products. Avon also pays a nice dividend, but now it grows at around 10% a year, and it's kind of started in value and ended in value. But I want you to notice there's always a lot of volatility in between, but over time, it's the actual rate of change of earnings growth that generates shareholder returns. Approximately a 10% growth rate gave shareholders a 9% appreciation, and then with dividends, about a 10% rate of return. But the point is, this 9% capital appreciation correlates very closely to the actual rate of change of earnings growth that was just tempered a little bit by some starting overvaluation. So that's a little faster growth. My third choice, and I thought I'd show a railroad that Warren Buffett might have missed. This is Genesee in Wyoming, which actually is actually an international railroad. But the bottom line is they're a 16% grower. They pay no dividend, but you can see how the stock price has tracked earnings growth. And, of course, like everything else, they had some problems here recently in the recession. But notice that shareholders ended up with a 16.1% compounded rate of return with no dividend, which correlates very closely to their earnings growth rate, and frankly is more than four times better than the stock market. And I want to emphasize here that, you know, is it the stock market? We're all worried about whether the market's overpriced or whether it's going to go up or down. But, you know, shareholders, owners, people that invested in this business, you know, did significantly better than the general stock market, and their return was correlated very closely to the return that the company generated, and therefore they shouldn't be worried about the stock market. And then my final example, a very fast growing company called Cognizant Technologies, which I believe is actually undervalued, has no debt in the balance sheet, has grown at 49% a year, and is, even though it's slightly undervalued, it generated over the only a 13-year period, it doesn't have a full 15-year history, a 47% compounded rate of return, and this is a 13-year period where people in the stock market would have obviously lost money. So the point is, what do people that own, what do the shareholders of Genesis, the real owners of the business, people that are buying the company, not the stock, what would they care what the stock market's doing if they own Cognizant Technologies? Hope this gave you some additional insights into the importance of earnings on investing. This is Chuck Carnival saying thanks for listening. I'll talk to you again tomorrow.